So now that we've done our process, we've done our outputs, then we move to our inputs. So for the inputs, we are going to use the six M's to see all those inputs or variables that will cause our outputs to go up or down, right? So manpower. So this one today, if we use more politically correct terms, this one should be people. Mother Nature should be environment. I actually like people and environment better. Six M's is easy for people to remember. So I'm going to go ahead and use the six M's for today. So manpower, that can be staffing, the number of positions that you have, the type of positions that you have, scheduling, vacation, overtime, skills, knowledge. All of these you're going to speak about without qualifying in terms of positive or negative. So it's not the staff is too many staff. We're just going to say staff, number of people on staff is something that's going to cause our numbers to go up or down. Methods. So these are our processes, standard operating procedures, industry standards, right? Measurement, how things are measured. So this is when we look at our outputs, are there things that could cause our outputs to go up or down simply because we measured them differently? So we see this often if I have a tall crane operator and a short operator, and they're both looking at the same gauge, they're both going to have a different perspective on what that number is. Materials. So this is going to be your tools. If you're working in a software company, this would be maybe your software that you're purchasing. Apps, things like that. This would be at a restaurant, maybe tomatoes, plates, pans, right? All those tools that you use, those materials that you use every day. Machines, that's where we get into our hardware. So if you're at a software company, you might get into your computers or your servers. All the equipment that you use to be able to execute your work. So compressors, engines, ovens, cars, computers, all of these would be examples of machines that, whether or not they work effectively, could cause our outputs to go up or down. Mother Nature. So these are really the environment. So the environment that you're interacting in a restaurant, you have this atmosphere that you've created. If you go into a restaurant and they're cooking jalapenos and it burns your eyes, or if you go into the restaurant and it's super humid and hot, those are things that the environment might affect your happiness or satisfaction with that restaurant. So acts of God can also be storms, hurricanes, earthquakes. It can be animals, pests, right? So this isn't just a restaurant focus thing. If you think about how hurricanes shut things down, COVID is a great example of Mother Nature. Right? Social distancing, all of these things have changed the way our outputs perform. Some people also use things like people, process, tools. That's great, but I'm always going to do a gut check on manpower, methods, measurement, materials, machines, and Mother Nature to make sure we haven't missed something. I think sometimes we have the tendency to say machines doesn't apply to us. And then you find out somewhere down the line that actually you never did some kind of a hardware upgrade, and now it performs at half the processing power that it should have. So here's the IPO template. This is available. This can be made available if you're interested in having this. It's something that we sent out to the people that attended the webinar. So we have our IPO here, which includes all of these inputs, right? So the number of staff on shift, that can cause our Yelp review to go up or down, definitely. The process of telling the cook the order. So are we sending the cook an electronic ticket? Are we going over there and telling them? Sometimes people try to take your order without writing it down. Maybe that's what the restaurant expects. That's a process that could definitely say the number of orders that you sent back went up or down. If you're talking about materials or tools, so maybe the app company that you use to be able to manage your restaurant, plates used. So sometimes when we get salads, we'll notice that the plate is hot. That's often because they don't have enough plates. They don't have enough plates to keep cool so that you would have a cool plate to have your salad on. That just came out of the dishwasher. Measurement. So I said here, customer receives food. What does that mean? Does that mean I received the bread? Does that mean that I received my dessert? Does that mean one person received the entree? Or does that mean everybody at the table received the entree? Right? So that definition of receives food could actually cause people to not get the right minutes from seating to receiving the food, right? We could have a number that's different for each person. And then each person doing the tracking might have a slightly different understanding of when they start or stop the tracking or the things that they're going to track. When we review Yelp scores, maybe I have a different perspective on things that are because of the staff than the manager does. Machines, you've got oven, stove, iPad, you have maybe the cash register, all kinds of things within the restaurant that you could attribute to machines. Mother Nature, so we're talking New York, they have rats, right? That's a problem that they probably have to deal with. Rain, if it rains, everybody wants to come in off the street, like we said, right? That could cause our fire code violations to go up or down. For safety, we could have health code violations, so that could go up or down. So here's our IPO template that you can use then with your team. This is the template. So to give you an update on this restaurant and what they actually experienced as a result of their deeper analysis into this, is first thing they did was they blamed the employees. They said, maybe you're not up to the task of serving so many customers, right? So that's not great for morale. That could be one of the things that we see in manpower, is we could have on here morale. Right now, if we measured that, we could also have some kind of measurement. So employee retention could be one of the things that we looked at for our outputs. Right, so like most restaurants in New York City, they had a surveillance system. So they went back and they grabbed their 2004 tape and they grabbed their 2014 tape and they compared them to see what the heck was different. So what they saw in 2014 was that the average time from start to finish for their customers was about an hour and 5 minutes. The average time in 2014 was about an hour and 55 minutes. I don't expect you to read all this. If you want to, you can go to the link and go ahead and take a look. So I find it fascinating here that really the catalyst or the variable that caused so many changes, or that the management team attributed to causing so many changes, were phones. So people were taking out their phones and trying to get Wi-Fi access. So the waiters had to spend 5 minutes helping them with Wi-Fi access. Strangely, a lot of customers didn't like where they were sitting. So I don't know why they didn't like where they were sitting. That would be something that would be interesting to get to the bottom of. So a lot of more people wanted to be reseated in the second review, or the 2014 review. For the phones, you see that on average, customers took 3 minutes taking photos of their food. Quite often during this photo shoot, their food got cold and they had to send it back to be reheated, right? So the management team in this example said, asked customers to be more considerate of the time that they spend in the restaurant. So I don't know if that's really addressing, well, I know that that's not really addressing the root cause, right? There's a lot of ways that you could identify some improvements that are not about customer behavior, which is a really hard thing to change. The other thing is that we did this IPO without knowing this video information. We did it without talking to the waiters. We did it without talking to the management team. And the way the management team seems to have written the article is it looks very much like they didn't talk to the waiters either. They said they blamed their staff for this happening, right? So I would actually step back and I bet if you did an IPO with the waiters, they would have identified the cell phones or the Wi-Fi as some of the inputs that are causing these times to go up or down, right? They would be able to identify that as a variable. So you have the IPO, what can you do next with it? Well, tons of cool stuff. You can take that process and you can break that down into a process flow diagram. You can go do some observations on it. You can take a look at some of those timings maybe so that you have that data for your minutes from seating to receiving the food. Now, with all of the data side, the output side, what you are going to do now is you're going to go ahead and assign teams to go after, or assign the actions to your team to go after these items. So when you leave that defined meeting everyone should have an action item to go get some of this measure data. So the next meeting that you come back, you're going to have your measure meeting, and you'll be able to review all of this data, right? Now, what data are you going to get? You're going to get things like about your process performance. You're going to be able to talk about the cost of poor quality, so the cost of doing nothing. You're going to get your baseline. So if we change nothing today, this is how it would continue to look. That you can get your COPQ from. You can start to talk to management about, if we don't make any changes, it costs us $20,000 a month, right? You can also start to see how your process is performing, right? So that if you do make changes, you can see that data change. Next, you can go ahead and you can see the trends so that possibly you can identify or start to identify root causes. So you can see maybe nights of the week where the weight is extremely high. What happened to cause that to happen? Maybe there's some kind of an event or a venue nearby that you know whenever that venue has an event, you're going to need more people on staff, right? On the input side, super cool. You can take all this and you can put it right on to an Ishikawa diagram, onto a fishbone chart. You can also do some deeper analysis on the variables. Let's say that you know the waiter is walking too much. Let's go ahead and take a look at how much they are actually walking. Let's do a spaghetti diagram. Let's do some five whys, right? Let's start to get down to those root causes. Now, do you want more information? I don't mean more information on the IPO. If you want to learn more about the IPO, you can certainly do that. I actually mean on the page. Maybe the input process output isn't enough for your teams and you want to see more. Well, you can do that. And you can do that by using the SIPOC, the supplier input process output or customer diagram, or you can use a turtle diagram, right? So both of these tools, and I just have the quick Google image search up here that you can go ahead and click on and go take a look at, right? These tools, or type in yourself, these have a ton more information. They both have the IPO in it, slightly different maybe in the way that they identify their inputs or their outputs, but they're tools that are incredibly dynamic, really good for before you do a value stream map or a Kaizen, to get a ton of information about your process up on the board. Turtle diagrams are probably great too before you design a standard operating procedure or anything like that. Get all that information out there. So today what I really want to make sure is that you understood that relationship between the inputs and the outputs, that you had the ability to recognize process inputs and process outputs. And then if you wanted more information on the tools that we talked about, the IPO, CTQ, 6Ms, you could go ahead and do that. Please join us for our happy hours. The next one is going to be June 2nd. July, it's always the first Tuesday, so you can take a look at Eventbrite, get more information. If you want to connect with me or to ask me any additional questions about this, you can connect with me at azim@beopportunity.com. Check out more about Lean Portland at leanportland.com. Thank you.